Hello students, this is Latika Nair from Samarpan Gyan School and today we are going to study English of class 7th, unit number 4, Ashes that made trees blue. So here children, we are going to study this chapter today, right? So basically in this chapter there are total 6 characters. One is 2 are the good couples and 2 are bad couples and 1 is the king and the queen, right? And there is one more character. I have not said this as a character, but then also it is a pet dog named Muko, and it is a pet dog of the good couples. Okay, so this is the characters of this chapter. Okay, so now we are going to start with the chapter. So basically in the introduction it is mentioned that this is a story about an honest and hardworking old couple and their pet dog. So the neighbors are very much troublesome and they are always troubling the good couples, right? And even they are disturbing this dog, that is this Muko. Right, and the dog dies a sad death. So the spirit of the dog gives solace and support to his master in very unexpected way. Right, so solace, it means that comfort in sorrow. That means that whenever these good couples are in a trouble or a problem, Muko's soul, that is the spirit of Muko, helps this good couple in very much unexpected way, right? So we will be seeing that which are the unexpected way and what are the helps done by Muko, right? So let's begin. So the ashes that made trees blue. In the good old days of the daimyo, there lived an old couple whose only pet was a little dog. Having no children, they loved it as though it were a baby. The old dame made it a cushion of blue crepe, and at meal time Muko, for that was its name, would sit on it and snug as any cat. The kind people fed the pet with the tidbits of fish from their own chopsticks and all the boiled rice it wanted. Thus treated, the dumb creature loved its protector like a being with a soul. So in this paragraph it is mentioned about the good couples as well as the bad couples, right? And it is also mentioned that about Muko the dog, right? That is a pet dog of the good couples. So and daimyos, it means the wealthy landowners, right? In Japan area in 19th century, mostly these wealthy landlords or owners were called as daimyos, right? So in this they have mentioned daimyos, right? So now these good couples used to care and love so much to Muko, and they treated Muko as their own child and gave lots of love and care to him, right? So you can see the how caring they were, right? They have made a cushion of blue crepe, right? And they have given it to Muko so that he can snug over there, right? In that cushion, right? Snug, it means it can be comfortable, right? And now they also gave the food, that is fish, and also the rice, boiled rice, from their own chopsticks. Means they were having the food by themselves, and while they were having food, they used to share the food to Muko also with their own chopsticks, right? So they cared this dumb creature, and they were the protectors of this dumb creature, right? The old man, being a rice farmer, went daily with hoe or spade into the fields, working hard from morning until 10 to summer, as the sun is called, had gone down behind the hills. Every day, the dog followed him to work. Right? So, in this, it is mentioned that every day this old couple, the female one, used to go, was a rice farmer, right? So, he used to go to the farm daily with a hoe and or a spade, right? So, here hoe or spade, it means spade is a tool used for digging. Now, hoe, it is a garden tool which has a long handle. And usually people use to dig it or just to turn the soil, right? Or else to remove the unwanted plants, right? So here this man used to carry this hoe or else spade with him whenever he was going to the fields. And it also shows that he went to the fields in the morning and he returned. He was working over there. Till O Tento Sama, that is the sun when it is going behind the hills, it means that evening time. So he worked from the morning till the evening. And even every day, the dog, that is Muko, used to go behind the farmer. So I hope you understood, right? Thank you.